Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 13 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, I showed you how to create video overlays. And in today's video, I want to show you how to easily set your frame range to encapsulate your entire movie. And I also want to show you how to do your first transition, which is one of the most common transitions in all of film, and that is the fade-in and fade-out effect. So, I've already imported Big Buck Bunny into the sequencer, and I've actually cut it up a little bit, cut it into pieces. And you can see that we have our black lines on the left and the right here. And that represents our frame range. And generally, when you guys want to animate this to your final video, you need to make sure that you set the frame range to encapsulate the entire video. And a lot of you may be actually just clicking your green line and trying to place it at the exact spot and then going down to the frame menu and setting end frame, which is one way that you can do it, but it's not going to be exact. And I'm going to show you a way that you can quickly do it and make it exact. So I'm going to reset it to there. So we have a frame range here to here. And what we can do is if you click on your sequencer and where you have your home button, there is a button next to it called page up and page down. Now what I want you to do after clicking is I want you to click that page down button, and you'll notice when you click the page down button, it takes you to the previous cut. And if I click my page up button, it takes you to the next cut. So let's actually keep hitting page down until it takes us to our first frame. And then from the first frame, we can actually continuously hit our page up button and watch what happens. It takes us to the very last frame of our strips. So we can then just go to the frame menu and we can set end frame, and now it has actually set it to the exact ending of our strips on the sequencer. That's the fastest way to actually encapsulate all of the frames of your video within the frame range. So now that I've showed you guys how to do that, let's do our first fade in and fade out transition. And where do we usually do a fade in for the first time? We do it at the beginning of a movie. So let's go back to the first frame in our frame range. And the fastest way to go to the first frame in our frame range is to go down to the playback controls down here. And we have this button down here. And when you press it right there, it will automatically take you to whatever is set as our start frame. And our start frame by default is set to frame one. Now, what do we need in order to do a fade in? We need a solid color to fade from, and we need footage to fade to. So we already have our footage here. We just need to add a color strip. And the way we do that is we go down to this add menu down here, and we go to effect strip, and we select color. And it's hard to see, but it actually placed a color strip on the first frame. And if we go over to the properties for that strip, we can see that it has a length of 25. It's only covering a small group of frames, or 25 frames, but let's actually zoom in with our box zoom and take a look at this closer. So I'm gonna hit Shift and B, and I'm gonna try to draw a box over the area I wanna zoom. And there we go, we can see this much better now. Now all you need to do a fade in is you need to right click on the color strip first, then we hold Shift down to do our group select, and we right click on the footage. There you go. Now all we have to do is go to the add menu and go to effect strip and go to gamma cross. And that creates a gamma cross strip on channel 4. And now it will actually do a fade in. Let's hit play to see what this looks like. There you go. Now, if you want to make an adjustment to the length of the fade in, all you have to do is right click on the right handle of this black strip right here, hit your G button and pull it out, and look, it will actually affect the length of this transition. So let's hit play. So that's how that works. Now let's actually go to the end of our movie, and we're going to first hit our home button to see everything, and I'm going to go to the last frame of our strips at the end of our frame range by actually going to this control down here. If we hit this, it will automatically take us to whatever is set as the end frame. Perfect. And I'm going to grab the background right here with my middle mouse wheel button. And actually, let's not go to the last frame. Let's actually place it just a little bit inside. And I'm going to go and go to the add menu and go to effect strip, and we're going to lay down a color strip on this side. Okay, now let's zoom in with our box zoom. Select over the area we want to zoom in on. There we go. And let's actually right click on the color strip, hit the G button, and let's place it so it ends at 14316. Perfect. And now we're just going to do the exact opposite. We're going to select our footage first. We're going to hold the shift button, and we're going to select the color strip. And now we're going to go to add effect strip, and we're going to do a gamma cross. And it created our gamma cross strip up on this fourth channel four. And let's watch what it looks like now. Fades out. Now, you guys can actually adjust this the exact same way. Just grab the left handle of the color strip and stretch it out, and that will give us a longer fade-out transition. So that should do it for today. I'll see you guys in the next video.